MLB The Show's coverage of Major League Baseball is on the air. Should be a good one here this afternoon between the New York Yankees and the Baltimore Orioles. Orioles baseball coming up next. Jorge Lopez gets the ball for the Orioles in this one. What do we need to know here, Danny?
Hey, this guy has a four-pitch repertoire, right? And those are a lot of nice options to have. You can go hard, soft. You can go in and out. And anytime you have four pitches, if you can throw them for strikes, you have the big advantage.
And that sends DJ LeMahieu into the box. And we are ready for some daytime baseball. The 1-1 home is swung on and missed, and that's strike two. The 1-2. Our temperature not quite 60 degrees, 59 here at game time this afternoon. Here now the 2-2. Rolled slowly down the third baseline, but a foul ball as it holds it 2-2.
Well, the key for him on the mound is to keep the ball down. Certainly, hollow of the knee or lower. Sinker changeup guy, if he's going to succeed against this lineup, he's got to keep the ball down.
Mullins, patrolling center, makes the play, one out.
Got it covered. The right fielder, number 99, Aaron Judge.
Digging in now for the Yankees, Aaron Judge. One out, nobody on. Skied into very shallow right. Santander will come in a bit and put it away for the second out of the inning. Next up, Aaron Hicks. First chance for him here in the top of the first with nobody on. He's set. Here's the 3-1. And he chased it in the dirt. The throw to first is in time, and the inning is over. Nothing doing here in the opening half inning. Yankees nothing, Orioles coming to bat. It's Major League Baseball on The Show. Jordan Montgomery, a hurler from South Carolina, will be the starting pitcher in this one. Dan Plesac, what do you got?
Really like this guy. He reminds me a lot of Andy Pettitte, left-hander from the University of South Carolina. Not an overpowering fastball, kind of like Andy Pettitte. Low to mid-90s fastball, good curveball. His secondary pitches, he needs to improve on a little bit, but this guy has a bright future. Quality arm from the left side.
Now the 1-1 pitch. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Judge is on his horse. He gets there and makes the play for the first out.
Batting second, the first baseman, Trey Mancini.
Ready now for Baltimore, Trey Mancini. Ready on 1-2. And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2. And a fastball blew it right by him, and there are two down.
Nice two-seam fastball there. You don't usually see a lot of swings and misses with that pitch unless it's really moving. So that one must have had some real good late life.
In now, Anthony Santander. Popped up. Torres is there. And he makes the play to end the inning. 1-2-3 go the Orioles. And this is still a nothing-nothing ball game. Second inning set to go, and standing in is the DH, Giancarlo Stanton. Here's the 1-1. And he takes one off the inside corner for ball two. And it misses. 3-1 now. Gleyber Torres waits on deck. Tried to crush that ball and now perhaps needs to shorten up with two strikes.
Hey, that's a good sinker right there. That's his bread and butter pitch, and if he's got that going, especially early, it's going to be tough to get some runs off him.
The next 3-2. Hit well towards the hole. Galvis is there on the first, and there's one gone here to start the second.
That is it. The shortstop, Gleyber Torres.
So bases are empty with one out now, and that'll bring up the exciting middle infielder, Gleyber Torres. Now the 1-1 pitch is strike two swinging. And right into the shift. And there are two away now. So two out, nobody on. And stepping in the dangerous left-handed hitter, Jay Bruce. Lifted the other way to left center. Left fielder is on the move. A dive, and he brings it in. And on a fantastic play, the inning is over. Worth a second look here, as this is a beauty to end the inning. Through an inning and a half, no score on the show. To the plate now is the designated hitter, Ryan Mountcastle. His prior history versus this arm, he's 1-for-2. And he lays off the breaking ball there as he moves ahead to 2-1. And that changeup makes him jump, a swing and a miss. Hit on the ground out to short. And that's the first out.
Batting fifth, the second baseman, Rio Ruiz.
In now for the O's, Rio Ruiz. Now the 1-1 pitch. And he goes against the shift there, as this is on the ground to the left side. Throw on to first will get him. Score at 5-3 on the putout, though it looked more like a 6-3 ground ball. Nevertheless, there are two away now. Now it'll be Michael Franco. He'll try to make something happen with two gone in the bottom of the second. Fouled off. Still looking for our first hit in the ball game. And the inning goes away in unceremonious fashion on a swing and a miss at a ball way outside the strike zone. Three up, three down for the Orioles. We'll move to the third with no score. And now in the box, Clint Frazier. 7-8-9, bottom of the order set to go here in the third. Come back with one in the dirt as the count moves to 2-1 now.
Lopez features one of the biggest yakkers in the game. Curveball's got a ton of movement. The 2-1 is a curveball that catches the zone for a strike.
I love everything this pitcher's got working right now. He's got presence. He's got great body language on the mound. He's got fastball command and a nice early feel for his off-speed stuff.
Throw to first in time, and the leadoff man is gone to start the third. So the next to bat will be Gio Urshela. Hot shot on the ground is short. Throw gets him, two down.
Batting none.
Two down, no one on base, and that'll bring up Gary Sanchez. Both teams so far yet to crack the hit column. Tough curveball that time, but he's able to make a little contact to keep this at bat going. The 2-2.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
Ready with the payoff pitch. Hot shot down the line. There is Franco. Throw on to first gets him, and the side is retired. So the Yanks go 1-2-3. Home half of the third coming up. No score. Digging in, the switch hitter, Freddie Galvis, as we move on to the bottom of inning number three. Into the corner and slicing foul. And he takes strike three called on the fastball, one gone. Austin Hayes the next to bat.
Austin Hayes.
And he gets him to lift one into shallow center field. After it is Hicks. He gets there, and that's the second out. Pedro Severino digs in at the plate. This guy's still looking at a zero in the hit column. A 1-1. Takes a pass and misses. That's strike two.
This pitcher's bringing it with some high velo. You better get that front foot down early and get ready, or he's going to throw it right by you.
A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. This one's down. It's the first hit for the O's, and it's going to be for extra bases. And the gamble will work out. He's in at second base with a two-out double.
Yeah, this one was starting to look like it was going to be one of those 1-2-3 easy innings. But now all of a sudden, they have the go-ahead run standing out there at second base after the two-out double. Big moment here.
Standing in now, Cedric Mullins. Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. Here's a little chopper up the middle, reined in. And nothing will come of the two-out double as the inning is over. Two-out double left stranded. Three innings in the books, still no score on the show. So the lineup flips over, and digging in, DJ LeMahieu. He flew out in his last AB.
The old adage, pitching and defense have been stellar so far. They've certainly kept both offenses in check.
The 1-1 home is looked at for ball number two. Well, if you love pitching and defense, this has been a game for you. Are you happy with that, Dan?
Oh, you have to love it. You know, Matt, we have so many of these games that are 12 to 10 and 9 to 8. It's nice to see a low-scoring pitcher's duel for once.
He's set, and the 2-1 pitch. Right side. He'll get to this one deep in the hole. Throw to first in time. One gone here in the fourth. Next for New York, Aaron Judge flew out in his only at-bat so far.
Almost, Matty. Almost went deep his last AB. Certainly just missed it. With this guy's big power, he's feeling pretty good at the dish. Look for him to try and get on something and drive it out of the yard this AB.
And a sinker not close as this misses down and away for ball four.
They haven't been able to register a hit against this guy, but at least they have a base runner here. We'll see if that leads to something.
So a runner at first with one out now, and that'll bring up the switch hitter Aaron Hicks. The Yankees still on the lookout for hit number one here. Ground ball to second. This could be two. Oh, and he has some trouble with it. Galvis. And digging into the batter's box next will be Giancarlo Stanton. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far.
Yeah, Matty, and it looked like a sinker in his last AB that got him to roll over. Kind of similar situation right here. Similar stuff on the mound. Look for them to try and get him to do exactly the same thing as his last AB. He's got to fight to get it.
A swing and a miss. That retires the side, and that will do it. Yanks leave one. On to the bottom of the fourth now, still with no score. Bottom of the inning now, and here comes the first baseman, Trey Mancini. Bounce towards the mound, and there's one away. Anthony Santander the next to bat. He popped out in his first trip.
Yeah, I don't mind him trying to drive the ball in the air, but he can't collapse the backside, and that's exactly what he did in his last at bat. Look for him to stay a little taller and keep that upper half a little bit more over him.
Full count now. Good battle. Count remains full.
Hey, that's just a great mix of pitches right there, and that's what this guy's going to do if he's going to keep this team off balance.
Fouled away.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
And he can only battle for so long as he's finally set down here after an eight-pitch at-bat.
The designated hitter.
So the bases are empty here with two gone, and that'll bring up Ryan Mountcastle. And the cutter got him swinging. Strike three, and the side is retired. 1-2-3 go the Orioles. Through four, still tied, nothing. Welcome back to Baltimore as we send you down to check in with Heidi Watney.
Thanks, Matt. I talked with the Yankees manager Aaron Boone during the break about the team's offensive performance so far, and he was pretty blunt in saying they're just not having very good at-bats. They've only managed one base runner in this game, so it's easy to see why he said they haven't shown much fight today. He's hoping to see someone step up and find a way to get something going, though. This game isn't out of hand, so it remains to be seen if they can snap out of this funk and climb back into this one.
Thank you, Heidi. New inning set to get underway, and that'll bring up Gleyber Torres. Three-two pitch. This is on the ground over to first. Fielded cleanly. And the fifth inning will start with a ground out, one away.
Now battle.
So one away in the inning, and here's Jay Bruce. No runs, no hits, and no errors for the Yankees so far. tough pitch to lay off there, but he did, and it's even up at 2-2. Just hung in there on that one. The 2-2 one more time. Smoked on the ground up the middle. That's a hit, the first of the game for the Yankees.
There's a hard hit ground ball. Pitcher not able to get a glove on it. Hard single up the middle.
Yeah, watch your lips right there, Dad. Sent it back right where it came from.
Into the box now, Clint Frazier. Scorched to third. Franco has it. There's one. On to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. They make it look easy, don't they? Around the horn for the double play to end the inning. Don't touch that dial or the remote for that matter. More on the show right after this. Welcome back for the bottom of the fifth. Here's Heidi Watney.
Matt, I had a chance to discuss the state of the Orioles offense with their manager between innings, and he told me he's pretty unhappy with their discipline at the plate in this one. He said their pitch selection has been the main reason for their struggles today, as far too often they've been swinging at pitches outside the strike zone. That's leading to a lot of soft contact and easy outs, so the focus going forward is on shrinking the zone and forcing the opposing pitching to throw more strikes.
Thank you, Heidi. The 1-1 home is looked at off the plate for a ball. Can't find the zone there, and it's 3-1.
If I'm in the box right now, I'm coming unglued. He is going to throw something over the heart of the plate.
The 3-1. Oh, and this ball is absolutely blasted high and deep into the flag court and gone. A solo shot down the line in right as the O's are on the board first. It's 1-0.
There's still some game left to be played, but that one swing could end up being a deciding factor in this one.
At the plate now, Michael Franco. And he fouls this one off. One run, two hits, and no errors for the Orioles so far. To the left side, but it's well foul. Now another 2-2. Line towards center field. That gets down, and he's got himself a base hit.
The batter, number two, shortstop, Freddy Galvis.
Digging in will be Freddy Galvis. First time up, he went down looking.
Yeah, Matty, and hopefully he got it out of his system, especially now he's got a bear down. He gets the two strikes in this spot, has to put the ball in play.
The 1-1. Takes this the other way to right, and that's in there. Base hit. They'll hold it second, and there are two aboard now.
Now
time will be called as we're going to get a visit from the pitching coach here as he'll hope to settle his guy down. So So now to the plate, Austin Hayes. Fastball swung on and missed for the first down.
Talk about blowing it by a guy. Jeez, I mean, that fastball was way behind him when the swing came through the zone. I have to think he was looking for something off speed, and he just couldn't pull the trigger on that fastball.
Stepping in now, Pedro Severino. Hit out towards second. And that's through, a base hit. And a good throw is going to hold that runner at third, so they're loaded now with only one away.
Nice execution right there. Ball was down below the knees. He stayed through it and was able to drive it for a base hit.
Into the box, Cedric Mullins. This one skied out toward right. Judge is under it, and the play is made, but this should be good enough for an RBI as the runner from third tags up. And he's out. Beautiful throw home to cut down the run. An absolute dime to the plate for the final out. Certainly worth another look. More baseball on the show right after this. Bring in Giovanni Urshela. He's set to start it out for the Yanks here in the sixth. A ball and two strikes. A couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. Ready to deliver the 1-2.
Outside, that's the ball.
So you'd love for him to offer at that one, but the execution was flawless. Nice curveball that starts in the zone and breaks just out. Just a great take by the batter.
Pulled high in the air out to left field. Under it is Hayes, and that's the first out of the inning.
Up next.
So next to hit is Gary Sanchez. He bounced out last time up. High and deep down the left field line. The 1-2 is laid off for ball two. Well, it's been a good outing so far, but he hasn't really racked up the strikeout totals that you might think, Dan.
Yeah, but for him, Matt, he's more of a pitch-to-contact kind of guy, and obviously it's working so far, and the way he pitches, it really keeps his pitch count down.
So we got him looking there. Gary Sanchez goes down for out number two in the top half. At the plate, DJ LeMahieu hit in the air down the right field line. In there, a base hit. And now it'll kick around in the corner. He'll get it into second. And he will pull into second with a two-out double. Finally, a little something for them to get excited about.
Yeah, a rally can begin with a single swing of the bat, and this might be their chance right here. They've struggled to produce a lot of runs, but there he is at second base. A shot to the outfield scores him. Then who knows what kind of role they could get on. Got to take it one good at-bat at a time.
Standing in now, Aaron Judge. Well below the knees, laid off on the changeup there. Just out in front of that one, still 2-2. Here's the 2-2. LeMahieu at second with two down. Swung on and missed, and that's the final out of the inning. Big time strikeout and some raw emotion as he gets out of the jam. The three of us are back after this message and a word from our local stations. So here's Trey Mancini. He'll get things started here in the second half of the sixth. 1-1. It's a fastball that misses. All even now, 2-2. And it's fouled away. And good patience to hold back on the curveball in the dirt. It's full now, 3-2.
What a great battle to start this inning. What a great job by the leadoff hitter. He knows that this pitcher's starting to get up there in pitches. The manager's starting to get restless. Let's see if we can knock him out and get into that bullpen.
And the throw to first is in time, one gone.
Now batting. Right.
So now to the plate, Anthony Santander, as the switch hitter will bat right-handed here. The 1-1. Bases are empty, one man out. Now here's one high and deep to left. If it stays fair, it's gone. And he just couldn't keep that ball fair as it winds up a long foul ball. Lined hard toward right center. And that's into the outfield for a one-out base hit.
Love the ability to push that ball the other way right there. Nice knock to the opposite field. That's a switch hitter's delight, the ability to use all parts.
Here comes the Yankee manager now up out of the dugout on his way to the mound. And we're going to have a pitching change as that's going to be off for his starter this afternoon. So he'll depart after 5 1/3 innings of work and with no shot to win the decision. Michael King enters to make an appearance on the mound as he inherits a runner at first with one out in the inning. Into the box now, Ryan Mountcastle. And he misses ball four. So he comes out of the bullpen and immediately walks the first man he faces.
The batter number 14, second baseman,
Rio Ruiz. Back at the plate now, and he's been the entire offense so far with the solo homer he hit earlier. Lifted the other way down the left field line.
Well, the O's have been searching for that big hit pretty much all game. It remains to be seen if they can get it, but now would be a great time for that.
Swing and a line drive. And that's in there, base hit. And they will hold that runner over at third as he'll move up only 90 feet, but the bases are loaded with one away. To the plate now, Michael Franco. And that misses ball four. A run will come in to score.
And this is a great example of what happens when you can't find the strike zone. The first walk of the inning looked harmless enough, but this one brings a runner home. Self-inflicted wounds are always the hardest to swallow.
So bases are loaded. Nowhere to put him with one away. And up next, the former Philly shortstop, Freddie Galvis. Hit hard to the right side. He's got it. Torres hit the bag. Relay to first in time. And just like that, this side is retired. Well, for better or for worse, when you seek attention, you might just get it. On to the back third here this afternoon. And we've got it for you on the show. Sean Armstrong is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number 7. So now here is Aaron Hicks. Lifetime against this particular arm. He's 0 for 5. The 1-1 misses for the second ball.
This is why the manager pencils these guys in the middle of the order. Big spot, time for them to get back in this game with a couple quality ABs.
Lined but speared on a hop. And the throw to first is in time, so the leadoff man is gone here to start inning number 7.
Up next,
Giancarlo Stanton now. He's 0 for 2 with a strikeout in this one. Now the 2-1.
A 3-1 count, tying run on deck. Good spot to be a hitter right now. You have to look for something middle in.
One out, nobody on. Fouled off.
3-2 counts are usually a time to challenge the hitter, but I think he'll be careful here. Shoot for the corner, and if you miss and you walk him, so what? That's better than him putting one in the seats.
Now the payoff pitch home. And right into the shift. Franco fields it cleanly, and that's the second out. Next up will be Gleyber Torres, 0 for 2 on the afternoon so far. Bases are empty here with two men out. One and two now as that one's fouled off. And the pitch. Lifted in the air out towards left center. And that'll get down for a base hit.
Boy, just when you're looking for one of those shutdown innings, you get two quick outs, D-Row, then give up a two-out base hit to extend the inning.
Yeah, you show me a big league ball player that's going to give away an A-B, no chance. Everybody's in there grinding every at-bat, every plate appearance. Nice job, maybe a little two-out lightning starting.
At the plate now, Jay Bruce in there, and it's full 3-2.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
Oh, this one bounces off the pitcher. Fortunately, he's able to stick with it and get the out at first, and that'll put an end to the inning. So no runs on a hit here, no errors, one man left on. Seventh inning stretch time here at the ballpark. Baltimore's out in front, 2-0. At the plate now is Austin Hayes, 0 for 2 on his line thus far. The 1-1. Here's a bouncing ball headed to LeMahieu at second. And he will whip this one over to first in time for the out. So here is Pedro Severino. He doubled earlier and carries a 2-for-2 line into this appearance. Bases are empty, one man out. Hit back up the middle. A diving effort here as he gets a glove on it. And not really much of a chance to recover there as he'll reach first on what undoubtedly will be scored as an infield single.
Nice effort by the shortstop right there. Kept it in front of him. That's all he could do right there, Dan.
You know, Dealer, in a spot like that, that's an infield single. That's a tough play. Just to knock that ball down was a pretty good job. But any way you look at it, that should be scored a base hit, and I'm sure it was.
On to first, and there are two down. Garen O'Day takes over pitching duties, looking to get that final out now here in this seventh inning.
Mancini.
Trey Mancini will be his first assignment upon entering as he'll bat with the runner in scoring position here and two away. The 1-2 pitch. And a swing and a miss there on a late-breaking slider as he set down on strikes for the second time this afternoon. Orioles leave one, but they hold a 2-0 lead. Paul Fry has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth. Now ready to begin the eighth, and that'll bring up the outfielder, Clint Frazier. A ball and two strikes now.
Someone on this offense needs to take it upon themselves to have a quality AB and start the line moving again.
Here comes the 1-2. And he wasn't going to hit that one with an or. The strikeout, and there's one gone.
Well, we've seen some really good pitching from these guys in this one. The bullpen has looked sharp and have backed up a nice effort turned in by the starter. These days, pitching has become a full staff effort, and I've been impressed with the job these guys have done so far.
In now, Gio Urshela. Lifted in the air out to right. Santander waits on it, and he makes the catch for the second out. Now to the plate, Gary Sanchez. It was a backwards K, a strikeout looking for him in his last at bat.
You know, Matty, tough to go down looking right there, especially in a long at bat. I kind of tip my hat to the fact that he didn't go into uber swing mode. He battled. He just got locked up. Look for him to have another quality AB. I think he's seeing the ball pretty darn big right now.
And another foul ball. Two out, nobody on. Another one sent foul. The next 1-2 pitch. Look out. That one almost got away from him. 2-2 now.
Well, what do you do when guys keep fouling pitches off like this? I guess you could back them off the plate by throwing one inside.
Now a fastball as he just reared up and let that one fly, and the inning is over. 1-2-3 go the Bombers. They're down 2-0. Bottom of inning number 8 set to go, and coming forward is the switch hitting outfielder, Anthony Santander. The 1-1 home. Misses, ball two. And some action out in the Yankee bullpen now as a right-hander starts to loosen up. The set and the 2-1 pitch. Ground ball right side straight into the shift. Torres brings it in.
Hey, that's a great job right there. Knowing he had time to collect himself, I love the internal clock right there. Didn't rush it, took the extra step, gathered himself, and threw a bolt to first base.
So now to the plate, Ryan Mountcastle. He loses him on ball four.
Man, the pitcher's wondering how he didn't get that call. Busted him inside on a 3-1 count, and the ump thought it was just a tad off the plate. Tough to get the benefit of the doubt from the umpire when you fall behind in a count like that, though.
Rio Ruiz to the plate now. It was a base hit last time up. Lays off the slider that time. 2-1. Now a move over to first, and he's back standing. Set to deliver on 2-1. Rolled slowly down the first baseline. To second for one, on to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. Nothing doing here this half. We've played eight full. It's the Orioles 2 and the Yankees nothing. Cesar Valdez comes on from the pen, hoping to finish this one off here in the top of the ninth. Set to start the ninth in this one, and that'll bring in DJ LeMahieu.
Yeah, it's always a nightmare taking on another team's closer trying to get back into a game, especially in the ninth inning. But having your leadoff guy up to start that inning is as good as you could have hoped for. So let's see if he can get something started here.
Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. Swing and a miss. Good pitch there for the first out here in the ninth.
When your closer comes in and strikes out the first guy he faces, everyone on the team can kind of take a deep breath. Still have two more outs to get, but retiring that leadoff guy is always huge when you're trying to shut a game down.
One out, nobody on. Sent on the ground out to second. He's right there on the first in time, and the Yankees are down to their final out now. Stepping in next, Aaron Hicks. And he needs to make something happen. They're down to their final out here in the ninth. And now this crowd announced at around 33,000 come to their feet. That's a foul ball off to the left, and it moves to 1-2. Last chance for the Yankees. A bouncer to the left side. There is Franco in the dirt, and oh, he can't quite dig it out.
And as a former pitcher, I can tell you, nothing is more painful than having to get extra outs in an inning. That should have been out number three there. Instead, he has to refocus and get back to work.
So it's a runner at first as a result of the throwing error. And digging in is the big-time power threat, Giancarlo Stanton. One strike from a shutout. Here it comes. That misses, and we're even at 2-2. Hicks is off of first with two away. And he strikes him out to end it here as they were able to get the possible tying run to the plate but could not cash in.
Pretty efficient game right there. Low scoring, 2-0 game, well played defensively on both sides, and a couple of runs is all it took in this one.
A 2-0 finish today. The O's used a nice fifth inning to take the lead, and they never gave it back. Jorge Lopez gets the W on the mound, so that'll do it for us. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to the new website, theshow.com.
Our final line score this afternoon, first for the victorious Orioles, 2 runs on 8 hits.